It's Deborah on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hi, Tom. How are you?
Great.
You know what? I just want to make a comment to you. I've been thinking about you for the past week or so, and
really?
I've been taking a shower thinking about what I wanted to say to you.
Really?
Really. But you might not like it, though.
Taking a shower thinking about me, huh? Okay.
Well, it's not good.
Oh.
See, the thing is, I think you are the world's greatest BSer I have ever heard on radio.
Really? How so?
Well, because, you know, I've come to the conclusion about you must hate really women, period.
No, I don't.
For you to give advice to men, you know, take them out on a date for $40 and get laid.
Yeah, well, how much should we spend?
Well, my value of what I am worth is not worth $40.
So you're a prostitute?
No, not at all.
Well, you see, your time is not worth no more than my time, dear.
So, then why be with a woman? So why don't you just...
Again, your time is worth... The fact that your time is worth no more than my time doesn't mean I want to be with a man. It means if I'm paying for your time, you should equally be paying for mine.
True. But
you that means...
But hold on a minute. You want something that I got.
Yeah, but point is, dear, that, again, many women call and say, what makes you think women don't want to get laid? But here you're implying to me that you don't really care about sex. You're doing me a favor by having sex with me.
Oh.
And by the way, if you're doing me a favor by having sex with me, I don't need you anyway.
Exactly. So why go out of the way and talk bad?
Well, the point I'm making is women who want to have sex with you don't care how much money you spend on them.
Well, you know what?
The only women who care how much money a man spends on them is women who don't like sex or don't want to have sex with that particular person.
No, see, because...
Yeah, because that, just like you just did, you act like you're doing men a favor when we have sex with you.
No, actually, I'm trying to think about how you need us badly. We don't need you.
Guess what, dear? I don't need any one of you badly, because every time one of you says no, there's someone else to pick up the pieces, someone else to do the heavy lifting down the block. There's always another vagina coming along. Vaginas are like buses, dear. Every 10 minutes, another one leaves the stop.
See, Tom, that's why I like you. Because you know what? You're great entertainment. Because you know.
But
what?
Also, what I'm saying is true. Do you really think you've got this special vagina that has these unique qualities that nobody else has?
You know what? That's right, because I know what I have, and it's good for me.
What you have passed its expiration date 15 years ago, dear, and now you're just kind of marking time.
No, we can say that we turn the tables around. We can say the same thing for you.
Well, you could, except I've got money, power, and fame. And even if you are not impressed with that, you'd be amazed how many young, hot women are.
Oh, I know. But still,
so it really doesn't matter. If you're not putting out, don't worry. Tut, tut, dear. There are plenty of other women who are happy to give me what I want.
Exactly.
For no charge.
So my thing is with you, Tom. I have this bone to pick. Why is it that you want to teach men so badly to treat women as if like...
I want men to have the same advantages in life I have.
Oh, that's the way it is.
Yes.
You know what? I think you are a very deeply hurt man within.
No, are you kidding me? Nobody's happier
than
I am. I'm the Pollyanna of America.
No. For a man that's been married 3 times, obviously you failed somewhere.
Dear, again, we're not talking about marrying. We're talking about getting laid. These are two different worlds.
Exactly. That's exactly. But my thing is that why do you want to teach other men... From what your bad experiences are.
I don't teach men how to get married. I teach them how to get laid.
No.
And the men who call this show always say the same thing. That what I have taught them has helped them get laid more often. And that's my job.
Oh, okay.
Getting awfully quiet over there.